It's just 40 days until the Olympics, when our best athletes test themselves against the world's best. But should the Games happen at all? Tokyo's in a state of emergency, grappling with its fourth wave of COVID infections, and Japan's death toll is around 14,000. Athletic teams are due to arrive in Japan within weeks, but Olympic organisers remain firm, even as calls intensify for the Games to be cancelled.
It's the Olympic dream. It takes passion, discipline.
And here comes Kereyn now, so strong in the second half.
But has the dream become a nightmare?
These people marching through the streets of Tokyo are not celebrating the coming Olympics, demanding it be stopped.
As Japan runs its own race to contain a virus before hosting the world's biggest sporting event,
I've decided to extend a state of emergency until June 20th.
Many are asking.
We are calling for the Tokyo Games to be cancelled.
Who will be the real winners and losers of this Olympic Games?
I think it's absurd that we're going ahead in these circumstances. It's clearly unethical and it will cost lives.
Does the pandemic risk keep you awake at night?
I am Emma Twigg, the women's single scull for the New Zealand rowing team. Been rowing the boat for close to 20 odd years now.
She's strong, ready, and determined.
You're out there at the crack of dawn, beautiful flat water, there's a bit of fog around. I'm exerting myself and trying to be better.
The hard work paid off in 2014 with a gold at the World Championships.
Being number one in the world was an amazing feeling. Something that very few people can say they've done. I remember having my family there, which was, also meant a lot to me. The great thing about sport is it's as much about all the people that have invested in me during that time.
But Olympic success has always been just out of reach.
I've been to three Olympics to date, and my first was Beijing as a 21-year-old, and I was 0.05 of a second from making the A final.
And Poland has just beaten New Zealand. What a heartbreak!
Then the UK.
I was in London, realistically a medal chance.
Kim Crowe takes the bronze. Emma is in fourth place.
A relatively devastating position to be when you're so close to the medals.
4 years later, in Brazil.
I was again a medal hope for Rio and crossed the line in fourth again there.
To one for the bronze. Emma Twigg out of the medals. It is Australia.
It was a crushing end to her Olympic dream.
When I crossed the line today, I had a kind of sense of that's it.
I kind of hung up my oars and decided that was enough and I was going to go and do other things.
She tried, but the Winter Olympics in Pyeongchang sparked the flame again.
I was watching our men's long track speed skating team.
The New Zealanders are going to have to put the foot down.
And they actually finished in fourth as well, ironically. Watching them try to be the best that they could be in their sport made me realise that it was a real privilege to be in that position, and I wanted a piece of that again.
So she's back on the water, pulling hard for one more chance at Olympic glory.
What I have control over is being able to line up on the start line and know that we've done everything in our power to put me in the best possible place to win an Olympic medal.
But what Emma can't control is this.
A fourth wave of the virus is leaving intensive care wards struggling to cope. The headaches for organisers continue. 10,000 volunteers quit amid concerns the Olympics will become a super spreader.
It's madness to hold an event of this scale right in the middle of a pandemic.
He's the epidemiologist renowned for helping New Zealand's successful pandemic response.
If you think about in a pandemic, the two things that you really avoid, one is a huge amount of people crossing borders and also mass gatherings. And the Olympics will bring people from over 200 nations and territories around the globe into Japan, mainly into Tokyo. This is exactly the opposite of what you do when you're trying to control a pandemic.
For Michael Baker, it's simple. Cancel the Games.
It's going to be very hard, in fact, I'd say impossible, for Japan to prevent some of these events becoming super-spreading indoor events. So this is absolutely the wrong time to be staging the Olympics.
And many, it seems, agree. Polls reportedly have up to 80% of Japanese people opposing the Games. But the IOC is standing firm.
We are go for July 23rd.
This top official, Richard Pound, saying it'll take Armageddon to cancel the Tokyo Olympics.
Yeah, I thought that was, not a view that I would be expressing.
She may not like the tone, but New Zealand Olympic Committee CEO Kereyn Smith agrees the Games should go on.
We're in the middle of a severe global pandemic. Why are we sending a team?
Well, New Zealand is sending a team because, you know, and our athletes have been working and training and preparing for this probably for most of their life.
And it's a record-sized team.
Probably around 215 athletes with a support crew of about 450. So it's a big family to be taking over to Tokyo.
Kereyn Smith is confident strict health protocols will keep our athletes safe. It's one area she and Michael Baker agree on.
Well, I think the risk to many of the participants is quite low. They're generally young and fit. Many of them are vaccinated, and they're going to be well cared for.
But therein lies the problem, says Michael Baker.
We know that vaccine supply is extremely limited in the world at the moment. Only 10% of the world's population has been vaccinated. So diverting vaccine away from frontline health workers and vulnerable people so it can support this event, I think is killing people probably every day around the world as we speak.
Wow, that's quite a statement. People will die. But you're completely at ease with that? There's no doubt in your mind?
There's no doubt at all. The Olympic Committee says 80% of the athletes will be vaccinated. If you add in the support staff and others going to cover the event, it's tens of thousands of doses of vaccine. So undoubtedly, people are dying now because of the Olympics.
We would never and never did advocate for Olympians to get vaccinations ahead of people. What we did talk about was about the fact that these athletes were going off to represent their country on the world stage, and that it was important for us to support them to as much as we could, and also to ensure that they could come home safely and also not compromise the Japanese health.
For Kereyn Smith, there's another picture at play.
This is about the world coming together but standing apart in Tokyo. It's showing a pathway for the future. Global life will start. The Olympic Games just happens to be at the forefront of this global path.
And in her playbook, Japan wants the Games too.
They want us to come to Japan. There are host cities that are reaching out to our athletes now, that are planning camps for them, that are really looking after them, and they want them to be there.
This is so at odds with what I'm hearing, which is that towns are shutting down and saying, we don't want you guys here. 80% of Japanese people do not want the Games to go ahead.
I guess in any country there's a variety of views, isn't there?
But 80% isn't a variety of views. It's 80% of the population saying, don't come, we don't want this.
Yeah, I mean, I have to assume that those numbers are correct. We see some different numbers, but whatever it is, if it's 40 or 80, there's obviously people in Japan that feel vulnerable and they feel that this is a high risk to their population. All we can do is do everything possible to make sure we adhere to the guidelines.
Last year, the pandemic was much less intense and it was said, look, we can't stage these events now, so they were deferred by a year. Now, things are much worse. In Japan, they're around 50 times worse than they were a year ago. Globally, over 30 times more intense. So why are we having the Olympics now?
How much of this decision to push ahead with the Games is to do with money?
It's hard to know. I mean, my sense of this, for what I hear every day, it's for the right reasons. It's all about the athletes. The IOC are committed for athletes to fulfil their dreams on the field of play.
Billions and billions of dollars are on the line. That must surely be an important consideration here.
There's no doubt the Olympic movement does power world sport. The IOC makes money and it invests it in world sport. So if it doesn't make money, world sport grinds to a halt.
What would it mean for the IOC if these Games are cancelled?
It's hard to know. You know, it's so disruptive in terms of contracts, in terms of broadcasting rights, in terms of financial situations support for the whole, I guess, Olympic movement in the world would certainly be impacted.
But if we don't cancel, the cost, some say, could be even higher.
So, Michael, this is the dream for our Olympic athletes, is to be out doing what they do so well. To cancel is a really big call.
It's a huge call. I mean, these athletes have trained all their lives for this. As a New Zealander, I love watching the Olympics and New Zealand athletes do well.
But?
I think the cost is too high to have the Olympics this year. The human cost is gigantic.
Does the pandemic risk keep you awake at night?
I have had a few sleepless nights.
But New Zealand's Olympic boss is resolute.
We're going, come hell or high water.
At the moment, we have complete confidence that the Games are going ahead and that our team will be there.
But what if the Games are cancelled? What will it mean for Emma Twigg's Olympic dream?
I think there'll be a moment of despair. I'd be lying if there wasn't. But at the same time, I think it's all about perspective, right? If it was cancelled, there's a great reason for that to happen. I don't think a medal defines who I am. What it means to be happy in life is just to be doing what you love, and I think that's what I get from rowing, and I've actually got to remember that.
Well, international fans are unable to attend the Games. Meanwhile, Tokyo's state of emergency is set to be lifted on June 20, and it'll be decided then whether local fans can attend.